the law offices of Hambert, Rendricks, and Loss. Mr. Hambert has been disbarred, and Mr. Rendricks is temporarily on the lam. But if you'd like to leave a message for Mr. Loss, begin talking after the beep.
Hello, Mr. Loss. This is Professor Schickele, the guy who wants to sue the American Musicological Junta to get them to reinstate me. Well, I finally obtained a list of the charges against me, you know, the things that led them to expel me, and it seems to me that I can easily defend myself on all four of these counts. Let's see, the first one accuses me of commercializing art. Now, this concerns a decision that I had absolutely nothing to do with and that I was completely powerless to prevent. I know that a lot of performing arts organizations are in dire financial straits these days, but I agree 100% with the AMJ that the idea of selling commercial time in the middle of a musical composition is utterly abhorrent. But like I say, there was nothing I could do about it, and I felt that I had to do whatever was necessary to get the piece in front of the public. Because I think that anybody who has heard this work will agree that whatever its merits are musically-wise speaking, it's an extremely important work historically-wise speaking. I don't think anyone, and I'm including the biggies here, Haydn, Mozart, whoever, I don't think anyone has created a more revealing portrait of the town of Thebes Gulch, Texas, than P.D.Q. Bach did in his dramatic oratorio, Oedipus Tex.